Reviewing your notes and life on a weekly basis is really important to reflect on the life you've lived and see the different ways that you can improve upon what you're doing all the time. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can use advanced relations within one database to do a nice weekly review in Notion. So doing a weekly review in Notion is actually easy enough. However, what could make it even better is having a relation on top of a relation within one database. So this is the Evergreen Notion workspace review area, and that's my advanced Notion template that you can get at riseproductive.com. But essentially how this works is that there are different parts of your life that you can assign different times to. So for me, I have work, rise productive, growth, and life. And on the alignment area, it can be seen that I would like to spend this amount of hours to these different parts of my life. So every week, what I can do is I can go in here and take a tree weekly time input. And essentially all I need to do here is actually use the functionality that's in front of me. I could put week for February work, and then I could actually take this and just duplicate this a few times and put in everything I wanted. So side hustle, growth, and life. Then what I can do is I can take these different things. So I could just quickly type in the different aspects of my life onto both of these different relations so that it aligns with the amount of time that I had given to it for this weekly goal that I have, the amount of time I want to spend on it. And then using some sort of time tracking method, I could figure out how many hours I actually spent on this. So for me, I know for a fact that I spent about 2,000 minutes at work this week because I had the Monday off. And then from there, what I can do is say, okay, I'm pretty sure I spent 20 hours doing this kind of stuff, which is what my goal is. And then I think I only spent about 6 hours doing this because I actually came down with being sick for a little while. So I wasn't able to do as much exercise this week. And then I actually did a fair amount of social things this week. I actually probably spent about 10 hours. So that's for me about what my goal was. So as can be seen here, this is functioning with some really nice spliced progress bars going on here. So this essentially takes the goals that I have from this alignment of this amount of time that I want to spend, and it has a progress bar leading up to there. So then what's really interesting, and the main reason that I'm doing this, is if I actually take this and go to weeks this month, I could make a new one and be called week for February. And I would grab all the different trees that I have, and those input weeks would be, as can be seen from before, just gonna grab the front part of that and just paste that in there. And then I could have all of these be added really quick. And what happens is it actually adds up the different amount of time that I spent doing those different things. And then I can give myself an overall score. I feel like it was like a 7 out of 10 week because of getting sick. I didn't get as much as I wanted to done. But what happens here is this relation is to itself in the same database. And I don't need to go back to the alignment goals because it actually takes the goals that I had from the alignment here. Because as I'll show in a later video next week, you can roll up a roll up by taking a formula from the weekly time goals that I had that was from the exact same database. So I'm rolling up a roll up itself right now, as can be seen from those input weeks, which the input weeks are in this exact same database. This input week property is actually relating to this exact property, this exact database here. It's relating to the alignment review, which is, as you can see, the database that I'm in. So then what I would do here is each week, I would use this template that I had, and as can be seen on the template, I have it all in front of me here as well. And I could look at how I did regarding the different parts of the alignment that I had. So I ended up having a pretty solid week in some respects. I spent a lot of time with people this week, which is, you know, it's always good to maintain your social life. I ended up spending enough time on my side hustle, but I didn't do as much working out as I wanted to, and I worked less than I could have. I mean, granted, I was sick, and I missed a day as well from just having the holiday off. So what I end up doing there is looking at the different successes that I had for the week. I ended up making about 8 videos in 3 days, even though I was sick, which I'm pretty happy about. I made 20 thumbnails this week. All of those different videos were entirely scheduled by the end of the week as well. Some failures is I didn't get up as much as I wanted to. This is pretty okay considering I was sick. But what I learned from this week was the fact that I am having trouble doing shallow work when I'm not working in the mornings on my YouTube stuff. So then the next steps that I'd need to take would be to utilize the time I have better by reducing the friction to do those monotonous tasks I could do on the go on my phone, increase the friction of what I don't want to do, which is mindlessly scroll on social media. And to be honest with myself, what I ended up having a lot of trouble with last week when I was sick was just, I was just binging YouTube, and I should have just been resting. And I didn't do it for an insane amount of time. I did sleep most of the day, but what I'm gonna do next steps wise is actually I'm gonna delete YouTube from my phone. So what I can do here is actually, as you can see, I have a capture inbox of all the tasks that I wanna do. I could take and make a new task really quick, just an ad hoc task, and I could just call it delete YouTube from your phone. And then it would be in my capture inbox. And I would actually call this growth. It's just me trying to improve my mental clarity. And then from there, what I could actually do is close that capture inbox and untoggle the ticking here. And actually, I have a content idea from this, which would be a newsletter content idea. And it could be about increasing and reducing friction. And then I could quickly write down the idea of talk about how you deleted your YouTube app from your phone as a YouTuber and only using apps like Audible and podcasts is what you're going to force yourself to do from now on.
If you guys like this video and want to see more on how to improve your Notion, click the end card right there. You'll like it.